What did you just say?
What are you right now sitting out here doing?
I'm minding my own business. What are you doing?
I don't think you are minding your own business.
Okay, what do you think I'm doing?
I'm not really sure, but I'll figure it out.
Okay, you figure it out. I'm probably where I live.
Yeah, I live here too.
Okay, so I'm probably at my house where I live. Got it. You feel good? Did you do what you needed to do?
What the f*** are you doing right now?
I'm standing outside my house. You're standing outside of my house.
Why are you standing outside of your house doing what you're doing?
I don't think that's any of your concern, what I'm doing.
Well, you're doing something.
Why don't you go back to your house and I'll be at my house?
You sound idiot.
You walked over from your house standing in front of me at my house trying to tell me I'm an idiot?
Absolutely, I did.
Okay, good job.
So what are you doing?
I think I'm doing none of your business.
Okay. I got more video. This was a black male who had his two kids, 13 and 5. They were playing Pokemon Go at the park. This Karen decided to follow him, obviously thinking he did not belong in that neighborhood. Karen realizes she's not going to win here. She embarrasses herself even more. Here it is.
Bye. And that's where she came from. She can't get out of the gate. She's like, she can't get out of the gate. Oh God, she can't get out of the gate.
Once again, the Karenicity, and this one runs deep. This is the whole show me your freedom papers thing they do when they feel as if you don't belong somewhere that they belong. Obviously, she did not belong where she was at, harassing this individual. I got names. Let's put up the picture of the Karen. According to the Twitter account, the individual is named Lisa F. Smith, is one of the neighbors of the black male. Let's put his picture up. His name is Joshua Miller. Mr. Miller is the founder and CEO of CNI, a video production company with multiple studios across the US and London. All right. She found the right one that night. Miller posted the encounter on his Twitter on Sunday, and by Monday afternoon, the emails and calls started rolling in Lisa's place of employment, and she has officially removed her Facebook page and removed her name and photo from LinkedIn. Yeah. All right. The harassment was reported to the police. Miller's wife called the police at 9:09 p.m. for an officer on site, but they did not arrive until about 11. Okay. They did take a statement. Nothing else happened. Fascinating. Karen strikes again. Thoughts here, Adrian?
You know, it's really upsetting that you can't call the police to necessarily aid you when you are being harassed by a white person because you are black and just living your life. In part because your phone's probably tied up because you're filming, but also because you never know when the police will show up and they will instinctively believe that you are the aggressor or that you are the one causing the problem. But the reality is, and especially in this situation, that woman was harassing him. She was also trespassing. She was committing a number of crimes essentially for which she needs to be held accountable so she doesn't do it again, because it does. It's very, very disheartening. It's denigrating. It really eats away at your humanity. And yet these individuals continue to get away with it. And I'm happy she's facing some public pressure. I don't necessarily know what's going on with her employment, but people need to get the message, and however they get it, that they cannot be out here regulating black bodies. I'm sorry. It's just, it's 2022. That stuff is, it's not acceptable. So I hope she faces real consequences.
Yeah, we'll see. Well, some consequences have already happened. You know, what the court of law cannot do, sometimes you can do justice in the court of public opinion.